it's very useful to understand the different generations. We can't understand each individual person of the 23 million Australians or the 7 billion people of our world. That's a lot of people. But by segmentation, we can understand a little bit more in a nuanced way our community and our world. There are lots of different segmentation approaches possible, obviously understanding gender differences or people by socioeconomic groups, obviously people by cultural background or geographical area. These are all useful segmentations. There are socioeconomic quintiles. There are divisions by gender or other background. But the generational segments is probably one of the most robust because it's multifactorial. People generationally are who they are, firstly, because of their age or life stage. A 20-something is different to a 50-something. That's part of the generational segmentation. Secondly, it defines not just your current age or life stage, but the times, the era that shaped you, the conditions, if you like. And so while we all might have been 15 years of age, we weren't all 15 years of age in the 21st century. And so the times, the events, the experiences that shape us, the influence, the milieu in which we were cultured or shaped have a big influence and create those different generations. And thirdly, the social markers, the actual events leave fingerprints on a different generation. And every generation has had massive events that have impacted them. It might be a political event, a big news event. It might be a technological breakthrough that has left fingerprints on that generation and shaped that cohort during their formative years. So because of the multifactorial influence of what has shaped us and age and conditions and events, we end up with different generations. Another way of saying it is it's just self-evident that a generation that came of age in the 1960s is going to be different to a generation that was shaped in the 1980s compared to this generation being shaped in this 21st century. So while the generational analysis is quite new, while there's a lot of hype, while a lot of generalizations are said, while we can't say that every one of the 4.83 million Gen Ys are all the same in Australia, obviously it's a useful activity to go through to understand the segment of generation and therefore to understand how to best communicate, engage, educate, employ, retain, communicate with a cohort based on their generation and their expectations, their influences, their attitudes, and therefore how to best communicate with them. I've written much about this in my book, The ABC of XYZ, Understanding the Global Generations. And I guess the point of that is to say that never before have we had the cultural convergence that we have today. Clearly, people are different by way of culture and country and the influences there that shape us. But take some 20-year-olds, one in Sydney, Australia, one in Beijing, China, they're going to be different to each other, culturally speaking. But they are far closer together as Gen Ys than their parents or grandparents ever have been. This is the cultural convergence. It creates the global generation. The technologies, the influences that have shaped the young people of our world are more connecting than we've ever seen before and creating the global cultures that we now see. So generational segmentation, generational theory, it's not the be-all and end-all. It's not the final step in understanding society and communities and people, but it's certainly a very useful first step. I commend it to you.